Burn, baby. Did I mention 4 Ezra? Yeah, it doesn't look good for mankind in 4 Ezra, or in Revelation 9. Yes, 4 Ezra is a very prophetic book. It is one of the banned books of the Bible, which I have read. I've read almost all of them. And for those of you who still question my interpretation of the book of Revelation regarding the red dragon and it being a reference to Asia, yeah, China, then have a read of 4 Ezra and see what you make of it. Because there are many references in 4 Ezra to Asia, okay? Yeah, look at this. What a terrifying sight appearing from the east. I like that one. The nations of the dragons. The nations of the dragons. Okay. Dragons of Arabia shall come out with many chariots. Yeah. And then there's more references to dragons of the east. Now, I'll find it for you, but before all of this, it mentions a great army arriving from the east and crossing the Euphrates River. Yeah? So they will most likely occupy the Middle East. Yeah, China. As Revelation unfolds, all these catastrophes causing wars. Yeah. And it just goes on and on about the East and the dragons. Here we are, the dragons again. The dragons, remembering their origin, shall become still stronger. Etc. etc. From the land of the Assyrians. See the clouds from the east and from the north to the south. Okay. Their appearance is exceedingly threatening, full of wrath and storm. They shall clash against one another and shall pour out a heavy tempest on the earth. And their own tempest. Now, again, I'll find it for you. But earlier on in Ezra, there's actually a description of an atomic weapon wiping out a huge multitude of people, again from the east. It's a pretty accurate description of a weapon of mass destruction, basically. Anyway, let's carry on with this here. There shall be fear and great trembling on the earth. Those that see the wrath shall be horror-stricken and seized with trembling. And then it talks about Babylon and Asia. Yeah. Beast and the dragon. Revelation. They're working together in Revelation. Well, yeah. Babylon and Asia appear in 4 Ezra as well. You, Asia, who share in the splendor of Babylon. Oh, yeah. You know it makes sense. You know I'm right. Yeah, I was so glad when I found this in 4 Ezra. Because it just confirmed my suspicions about the dragon in Revelation 12, also a appearing in 13, but being Asia, being China. Yeah, they really obliterate the place, look. They pour out the tempest and all its fury. Tempest and all its fury. Dust and smoke reach the sky. Man, I mean, this is, well, we're looking at World War III here. Revelation 9. You have the four angels set loose in the Middle East, you know, bound by the Euphrates River. The four countries in the Middle East, Turkey, Syria, Iraq, Iran, set loose to wipe out one third of mankind. One third of mankind, yeah. And there's also this about Asia and Babylon, yeah, who caused much devastation also. Or maybe we are talking about Asia and Babylon in Revelation 9, who do all of this. Because China will invade Iraq and Iran, or simply occupy, and then cause all of this, all this devastation, wiping out a third of man. Yeah. And then, oh yeah, hang on. It talks about Asia persecuting Christians. Oh, there's a great, more confirmation, yeah. The most persecution of Christians in the world is from China. And it says here, I'm going to read it. Yeah, I will set all of these things upon you. Yeah, this is what God says. You shall be weakened, like a wretched woman who is beaten and wounded, so that you cannot receive your mighty lovers. Would I have dealt with you so violently, says the Lord, if you had not killed my chosen people continually. Exulting and clapping your hands and talking about their death when you were drunk. Look at that. Persecution of Christians. China and the Middle East. Muslim extremists. Get a load of that. More confirmation that it's China, Asia, East, dragons, land of the Assyrians, clouds from the East, Asia, Babylon, Christian persecution. Oh yeah. Done it again, Luke. Done it again. So, my interpretation of Revelation is correct. Please check for Ezra and other apocalyptic books that have been forgotten from the Bible. Yeah, torn out. This is a very apocalyptic book. I've been through the Apocalypse of Abraham as well. That one's interesting. I've been through, all the infancy books, books of Adam and Eve. I've read the Gospel of Thomas, Jubilees, Jasher, all the books of Enoch. Loads of them. I know what I'm talking about, right? I know my prophecy. And I'll tell you what, I know exactly why the Council of Nicaea chose to reject some of these books. They're too revealing. They come up with all kinds of excuses, like they don't think they're God-inspired. Oh yeah, who makes that decision? Very God-inspired, some of these books. But they just don't want people to know. These books are gold dust for a prophecy scholar. They're amazing. They tell you everything. Yeah, everybody's struggling to interpret Revelation, but if you read some of these lost books, it's perfectly clear. Aha, here we go. Yeah, I was wondering where all my highlights and notes were in the book that we were just looking at. Yeah, it's a different translation. I've got two versions of the lost books of the Bible. Yeah, this is the lost books of the Bible and the forgotten books of Eden. Now, the other one, this is what I was reading on my phone and made loads of notes on. This is banned from the Bible. Books of church banned, rejected and declared forbidden. And this is the one that has all my highlights and notes in it. So here we go, look. Asia. Woe be to you, Babylon and Asia. Yeah, similar to this one. Woe to you, Babylon and Asia. And many references to Asia here. Let's go through some of these notes, shall we? Yeah, here we go. Where the nations of the dragons of Arabia will come out with many chariots, and the multitude of them will be carried as the wind upon earth, that all they which hear them may fear and tremble. Crossing the Euphrates, coming from the east, and dragons, quote, of Arabia, just like in Revelation, fiery dragon, Revelation 12. So, when it says dragons, it is, as I thought, referring to a nation. Nations of the dragons. Now, I say China, but it might also be Arabia, as it says here. But what I think is it will be China occupying the Middle East. So it's going to be Chinese and Arabs. Yeah? Chinese Muslim invasion. That's what we're looking at here. And they both like to persecute Christians, don't they? Let's have a look at some of my other notes. So many references to the east there. Here we go, check this out. Oh, you're going to love this one. The glory of your power. Yeah? Asia's power. You, Asia, partaker of the hope of Babylon and are the glory of her person. Revelation. Red dragon gives power and authority over to the beast. Yeah. Revelation 13. Power. Right, so I'm going to go back and find my other highlights and notes where it talks about the invasion coming over from the east, crossing the Euphrates, and this weapon of mass destruction that wipes out a multitude in an instant. Yeah, here we are, yeah. They entered into Euphrates by the narrow places of the river. Right. Yep, foreigners invading China. Where is it? Where does it mention this weapon of mass destruction? Right, let's go back. I think it must be before this. Oh God, look at all this. Whew, loads of it. Here we are. After this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of the heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea. The man that came out of the sea, yeah, it may be talking about the 11th horn Antichrist here of the book of Daniel. Daniel refers to him as the 11th horn. Yeah. It says a man came out of the sea. Now John says a beast comes out of the sea. But it's not a man, it's world government, okay? So that's interesting there. All they which were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid, and yet did fight. But only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire. I mean, that's brilliant, that, isn't it? Talking about a red dragon in Revelation. Well, get a load of this. I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire, and out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempests. Red Dragon of China, once again, the first beast. I don't know, the, yeah, Revelation 12 dragon. That's meant to say. I think this must be where we're talking about the weapon of mass destruction. And they're all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude, which was prepared to fight, and burn them up every one, so that upon a sudden of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived, but only dust and smell of smoke. When I saw this, I was afraid. There you go, folks. We've got an ancient book of the Bible here, describing a weapon of mass destruction. Now, I did do a video on this for Ezra a while ago. Yeah, look at this. Completely pointless fighting the communists in the end times. This sounds like nuclear war. And there won't be any fighting because this multitude, which is prepared to fight, are burned up, everyone. All of a sudden, nothing was to be perceived but dust and smell of smoke. Wow. Look at how apocalyptic 4 Ezra is. And it matches with Revelation 12 and 13. Yeah. So, dragons from the east. There you go. Chinese communists. Coming together, possibly with Muslims. Yeah, because they both like to persecute Christians. That's going to be the agenda in the end times, isn't it? Let's see what else we can find. I mean, I went over this a long time ago, but I was going through the fiery dragon in Revelation. And then I had another look at 4 Ezra and found all these mentions of Asia and the East. Oh, here we go, we've got more of it. This is talking about world government heads, yeah. But then it talks about something coming up from the sea as an eagle. 3 heads. Yeah, another reference to heads. Now, I've changed my viewpoint on the heads. I thought they were continents originally. It was the best way I could, decode Revelation, you know, explain the 7 heads, 10 horns, and 10 crowns. But I've done more research into it, and I've seen what others are saying, and I think we may be talking about governments, empires. Yeah, the heads could be empires. That's the only thing I'm unsure about, these heads. Anyway, you get the picture. For Ezra, weapons of mass destruction, wiping out multitudes and turning them to dust, and dragons from the east. Woe to you, Babylon and Asia, beast and red dragon.